Hello and Happy New Year. I'm Alex McCord and you're watching The Real Deal on TheStir.com. I am broadcasting to you from sunny Australia where it is summer. And it may be hot here, but it was even hotter in Atlanta and Beverly Hills with all the shenanigans of the housewives and the house husbands. Are you ready? Let's jump right in. Let's start with the Atlanta men, particularly Chuck Smith. This week, Chuck got the build them up and tear them down treatment from Bravo. He looked wonderful while setting up a boys and girls trip to Athens with Phaedra and Nene. They all spoke, the ladies played basketball in heels, and all was well. Now, if you're catching up on previous episodes, you'll remember that Chuck dated both Phaedra and Candy in high school and college, and neglected to tell his wife, Monique, about any of it. On the way home, first he farted in the car, and then he dropped an even bigger bomb by denying that either Phaedra or Candy ever meant a thing to him. Phaedra and Candy were part of a team, part of his harem. He was a young multimillionaire, and he lied to them in order to sleep with them. Okay, let's discuss. First of all, in real life, that's a terrible, horrible, a-hole move. But in reality TV land, Chuck's simultaneous owning and dismissing the ladies was a brilliant, if jerky, move. If he and Monique are staying on the show, he did well because he owned it and he dismissed it. Great strategy. But the same cannot be said for Peter and Cynthia. Lordy. There are lots of things stressing out the Bailey household. As we know, the daughter is dating and that's scary. But also, do you buy for a second that Sister Mallory showing up unannounced to come and stay with them for 2 months was organic? I think that was cooked up in a production meeting. It's significant that she's staying for 2 months, because that's probably the remainder of the production period since we're about halfway through. In any case, it is certainly not helpful to Cynthia and Peter's relationship that Mallory has shown up. She might be being tried out as a friend of the housewife, or a new housewife, or a last-ditch effort to keep Cynthia's story relevant on the show. We'll see. But let me just say, my husband and I never, ever go out and buy things without consulting one another. I think this whole new car thing is very shady. And I did think it sort of served Peter right that Mallory showed up unannounced to stay for 2 months, just as Peter bought a new car without telling Cynthia. But let me put on my behind-the-scenes hat to discuss this husband and wife struggle, right? Cynthia has been a TV star for several years now. And although he's not an official star, he doesn't get paid, Peter has become infamous in his own right due to appearing on The Housewives as Cynthia's husband. What happens when these husbands get sucked into the drama? Viewers develop opinions about them, particularly in Atlanta. The men are always in the doghouse. Now turn that back into the real world, and what do you think happens? These men become unemployable. If a house husband tries to go and work in an office, all the co-workers want to take pictures of him all day and sit around the water cooler and discuss and have them call their mothers. They don't get any work done. Being a house husband means you can't work because the show swallows up your life. Now remember, Peter doesn't get paid for his participation, so basically what has happened is Cynthia is supporting the whole family on her housewife salary, plus whatever celebrity gig she can get on the side. Now the housewife salary is great if you're a two-income family. However, if you've got a family, kids, a mortgage, it's all going to go south pretty quickly. So, Cynthia is the breadwinner. Peter is off buying luxury cars without asking her, and berating her for not having enough sex. If you were in Cynthia's house, wouldn't you be mad? And where does that leave Peter? He looks like a jerk. And no boss in the world wants to hire a jerk. So you think, fine, I'll go into business for myself. Well, unless you invent something that the world cannot live without, nobody wants to do business with a jerk anyway. I hate to say it, but having a man cave is not going to be enough for Mr. Peter. He needs to either step back and support Cynthia fully, or leave her so he can blame all his problems on reality TV, turn his back on everything, and rebuild. Speaking of living large, let's turn our attention to Portia Stewart. I was thrilled to see that Portia finally realized that it was time to cut the cord and the cordel, move out of Mama's house, and move on with her life. But if Mama is paying for all the doggy accessories, how is Portia going to afford this 8,000 square foot house in Nene Leakes' neighborhood? Look, I would imagine Portia has a sweetheart deal with the owner of the house to rent it for 2 months, market it on the show, and then the owner will probably sell it after it's starred on The Real Housewives of Atlanta. One good thing about Portia moving out of Mama's house is that Mama and the kids no longer have to film and not get paid for it, because of course Portia's salary covers Mama and the siblings' participation too. At least she doesn't have a husband and kids. They can get back to work, and Portia can have the run of the new house to film the show, live large, throw parties, try to keep her place on the show. Now, I hope that this is what is true. I hope that Portia is being smart. Now, if she is not smart, she could be spending actual money on this house. I seriously hope that's not the case. Now, someone else who seems to be cracking under the pressure of being on reality TV too long is in Beverly Hills, Miss Brandi Glanville. Woo! It got so bad this week that even Lisa Vanderpump wrote her off. Here's what I'm guessing happened. I think Brandi Glanville has had a Jill Zarin moment. She got way too big for her britches, and she assumed that people would do whatever she said. Now, this can happen very quickly when you become famous like you do on reality TV. Now, if you don't like the attention, but you manage to deal with it semi-gracefully and not punch any photographers, then you're fine. But if you like the attention, it gets addictive like a drug, and it makes you think you're the king of the world, and everybody has to bow down to you, and it is a slippery slope into bad behavior land. Brandi probably made enemies of both the production company and the network by being too much of a diva, and they got back at her. Because guess what? You don't control the editing. And if people get angry at you, they can screw you. And I think that's what's happening this season. It's hard to fight back when you don't have any control. And you also can't control other cast members colluding and ganging up on you to provoke you. My Monday morning quarterbacking for Brandi, stop drinking on camera. Brandi had the potential to be the Bethany of Beverly Hills, but guess what? It looks like she's the Sonya. Ouch. Okay, what else happened in Beverly Hills this week? Do you think I'm going to defend Carlton again? Because I'm not. Yes, by all means, have a dungeon or a playroom in your house to spice up your sex life, but don't make your mother-in-law uncomfortable. Carlton was trying to be provocative and ended up just being downright rude. The reason these sex rooms are hidden away in one's house is with locks on the doors is so that your family doesn't have to hear about it. Ever. Finally, we come back full circle to Atlanta, where apparently new mama Kim Zolciak wants back into the peach pit. Here are a few reasons why Kim could want back onto the Real Housewives of Atlanta. Number one, when you are part of an ensemble cast, you don't have to do all the heavy lifting. You're not carrying the entire show on your back. They have six or seven families to cover, so you're not working every day, and you can deal with your house and your children and your husband. Two, although her spinoff has had good ratings, Don't Be Tardy hasn't officially been renewed for a further season. Now, if Tardy hasn't been renewed, Kim's not getting paid, and for all the reasons we discussed earlier, that would be a problem. Let me know what you thought in the comments. Do you think that Kim Richards is really truly Alpha Kim now? Do you buy that? What are your odds for Peter and Cynthia staying together, and do you think there is any hope whatsoever for Brandi Glanville, or is she done? Let me know what you thought in the comments. For now, I am Alex McCord. You're watching The Real Deal on TheStir.com. See you next time.